A great new variation for Black in the Spanish opening, also known as the Ray Lopez. How can that be? This opening has been around for 200 years, and out of the blue, boom, there's a new line for Black, and this is pretty smart, and you should use it right now, because it's a great surprise weapon with a lot of poison, a lot of great positional ideas, and at the moment, White simply does not know what to do, and I can prove it to you. So here is the complete course in this new line for Black. If you look at the position, you see that we will take it from the beginning, e4, e5, and this is known as Spanish, and this is the main line, this is the main opening, and a6, and White can of course take on c6, that is known as the exchange variation, but clearly the most played move and is bishop a4, this is also the best move. And bishop c5, this was played by Jordan van Forest against Arjan Tari in the recent Vaik and Zee tournament. And why is what's the point of this? Well, first of all, you like the bishop here on c5. There is the Cordell variation, but there's also the new Arkangel and the Arkangel where Black places his bishop on c5. So it's a good place to go. So why has this not been played before? Well, I don't know, because it makes a lot of sense, because in this position, bishop c5 is a very well-known line. And I think the reason is that it was considered that a6 was not such a good move to have in when White takes on c6, because in some lines you do have a6 for the bishop. But that's it turns out there are some funny tricks for Black, but the main point will be revealed here. In this position, Tari played castle. This is what most people will do with White, I think. Later on, Geary went on to play Van Forest, also in the same tournament, and Geary is very well prepared, and he played c3, and it went like this. And this is the point. You want to put the knight on e7. I'm going to show you in a little while. And it went like this. And all this looks a bit like an Italian game. And d5. And notice that knight on is not on f6, so it will not be hit by e5. And here, after this, Black was more or less okay. I think in this position, a better move for Black is bishop e6. And I think Black is really, really, really close to equal here. He has a very, very good bishop, bad pawns, very strong bishop. The bishop will sit on d5, and yeah, he should be okay. Okay, but c3 was the idea of Geary, and he made a draw against Van Forest. The end position was this, where they will have 3 versus 3. Okay, castle, and here comes the point. Knight d e7. It looks less active than putting the knight on this square. So why do you want to put it on e7? Well, there are different reasons. First of all, this square is a very nice square for the knight. Often in the Spanish game or Italian game, you see that White moves his knight to something like, and here, and Black also do this, and here, because the knight is strong here, where it aims at these squares for the attack and defend this square. So we are putting the knight here to put it on g6, and then maybe later queen f6. Another idea, which is also a very nice feature of this position, is that if White goes something with d4 and e5, there is no knight to hit on e5. So there is a, it's sort of out of the way. Also, Black can take back with the knight on c6 if White takes, which is nice. But the real point is probably that Freddy down here is free to move, and Black has a bishop on c5, so maybe if we can go here and we'll have this, then this square might come under attack. So this is the all the points. So what's the downside? Well, there is not many downsides, actually. One downside could be that maybe White should try this move. This has not been played in any master games. Black plays something like this. And here Black is threatening, trapping
this guy. White has the bishop pair. White, black is maybe slightly better developed. The bishop will be good. The computer says white is slightly better. Probably right. On f4, you play c5. And you will not lose anything. For sure, you just go c4 next. In most of the lines, I think. Or you can move the knight. But anyway, this might be critical. Nobody plays this, so you should not expect this. Most white players want to play c3. This is why they play the Spanish, to build a center with this pawn coming here, right? And getting these two pawns here and having more space and good chances for attack on either side of the board. So this is the what white will play. And black plays bishop a7, aimed at d4. And white says, okay, you're not threatening e4 like you used to, so d4, and here we go knight g6. Now this is it getting interested, right? Black puts the knight here, and in this position, white has different options. First of all, black would love to just castle and play d6. Maybe h6, queen f6, maybe king h8, maybe f5. His position is fundamentally nice. He will have only, if you look after a move like d6, all black's pieces will be strong, actually. So, there's no bad pieces. The bishop on a7 will be in the game, the bishop on c6 will be in the game. So here, white has to make a choice. In most of the game, from this position, he's played bishop f5. d5 to provoke f6. I'm not sure this is a good idea. I think this it looks a bit weird, but it does win a pawn. And here, white should be careful, of course. If he takes here, then we get something like this. And here, black is already much better. The bishop is strong. He has very active pieces. And d3 and c4 are weak. So this is not what black wants. Instead, here takes, you can take with the knight, and you should take, of course. And in this position, Jeffrey Xiong played against Chigalco. He took on d1. I think probably a better move is queen e7. You do want to maybe castle queenside and launch an attack. So the idea is of course you're directly threatening this pawn. I think his main move is queen f3, and here just to avoid any to be able to play simple chess, h6, and I think black has decent compensation here. If white plays bishop e3, you take it and take on e5, and you'll have this bishop versus knight. This can be sometimes be a problem for the bishop, and sometimes it's very good. Anyway, when white has played c3, like he has here, all the white squares here, they are all weak. So there will be, maybe not c4. Anyway, the white squares will be weak. So this bishop will be strong somewhere. This is the pride and joy of black's position. Also, white gave it up just to win the pawn. I think black has good compensation here. I played this in Blitz with good results. I think in general, it seems white doesn't have any idea how to handle this position. But this could be critical. This is my recommended. Like I said, Xi Young played this against Chigalco, and it was a draw in a title Tuesday on chess.com. The common move is bishop d5. This is also what Tari played against Van Forest. And this is interesting. Also, what Contronius played just a few days ago in a tournament in Beograd. And why is that interesting? Because Cotronius is a very, very strong theoretician. He wrote many, many books on openings. He's known for really working hard on the openings. And he didn't have better than bishop d5. He didn't have an idea for white. Maybe he didn't study it, but he sure didn't have come up with anything. Okay, after bishop d5, this f6 is forced. White goes back, bishop e3, castle. And this is all normal. If you take on e5, you'll just take back with the f pawn here. I kind of like black's position here. If you're left unobstructed, you'll just go d6 and king h8 and Freddy is coming. He's coming for you. He will and you will get an attack, and this bishop here is good. All the black pieces are good. This is, you can only dream to get a position like this usually in these openings. So white decided to go d5 immediately here, and in this position Terry took on a7. Cotronius played this move, and because in this position white is very afraid that black is allowed to play this, because after that he will have a great sort of King's Indian Benoni like structure. F5 is coming, and there's nothing white can do about it, and you're sure to get some sort of attack on king side. And this is what we like, right? With black, after just 10 moves, being we're sure that we will attack on the king side and not white. So whites tend to panic here and play d6. I think it's correct to panic, because black's main idea is just to go d6 and f5. And there will be fun on the king side. So in the Cotronius play, d6, it came like this. And here black played b5, and I think he was probably inspired by Van Forest against Tari. But I think a better move here is actually to go d6. This is a novelty, and it looks weird with this bishop here, right? Looks strange, something here. But it does cover this pawn, and black is ready for f5. So I'll go f5 and f4, and when this bishop moves, this guy here will go back and be a real menace along this diagonal. So this, I think this position is already better for black, because the weakness here is easy to cover, and you have the initiative with f5 coming. And I don't think so b5, don't play b5, play d6 here. Okay. In the Cotronius game, went like something like this, and it ended in this position where they took a draw. We'll be back with the Tari game here. Tari took on a7, take, and d6, and of course, again, he's afraid that if left unobstructed, black will just go d6 and f5 with a great position, two knights to attack on the kingside, and a bishop, and the queen, and the rook. And white doesn't have much play. The bishop here on a4, this guy, let's make him yellow. He's out of the game at the moment. He will probably go to c2, but not mostly just to be exchanged. So the proud bishop is not much. So white tries to sort of make disrupt black's position. It makes sense. And b5. Liberating and getting ready to get the bishop out here. Starting to sound like Arnold Schwarzenegger, everybody down. Bishop b3, king h8, a4, bishop b7. White did have some initiative, but black is simply planning bishop b6 and bishop rook b6 and bishop b7. And here comes, boom. And now he's getting out. And here, black is already better. He has great pieces. His position is solid, and as we will see in a minute, also there's something that I'm sure that a cunning attacking player like Van Forest is looking for. He's looking for this rook to go somewhere like here at some point after Freddy has joined the action. And the finish was quite nice. C4, white is desperate to get some play before he's just run over, but it doesn't matter. This black simply is much better here. And we see that, and it's kind of instructive. Now all black's pieces are joining the attack. The rook here is going to g6 or h4. The queen here is coming to d5 or h4. The rook here is already playing this guy down here. And this here, and this position is horrible for white. He's a disaster. And he panicked completely, played knight f3. And here, and this is simply lost after this smart move. Now, he cannot take it because of the check here. So if you could do something like this, There's this check. Rook e1 goes, and here turns out this constellation is not so good. There will be a pin, and black can actually manage but white managed to make a lot of noise and not be mated, but now he loses something due to this problem. Also, we see that the X-ray effect here is pretty nasty. Queen c3, covering the knight, but there's no help. And d6, and this something simply drops. And white could resign here. He played this, and well, went like this. And here we see that just notice he was just one last trick, and Van Forest saw that. And by the way, Jordan went on to win the tournament. What a wonderful surprise that the one of the lowest rated players actually wins Wigan C. This used to be the tournament for Carlsen and Anand and players like that. So that some Dutch local guy, I don't know if he's local, but that he wins. Of course, he is a very strong player, but we are not used to that. Anyway, this Spanish surprise weapon, brand new line, is very interesting. Just a6, bishop c5, and knight to d2, e7. We'll just make a short recap. e4, e5. And of course, you need to learn the King's Gambit. Here you need to learn the Scottish or the Italian and all these things. But this was not the topic today. The topic was this line. And I think it's very interesting just to do this. And white has simply no idea how to play. If I played a lot of blitz game where they go something like this, and you just castle, and they'll go something like this. And here, white is very quickly running out of ideas, because the only idea in the opening is to go d4, and black will follow up. In some games, I managed to play this move. And in other games, I played knight here, queen here. Remember to play this first, because of this square bishop d5 might be annoying. But and put a knight on this juicy square and getting a lot of attack. And I think at the moment the ball is definitely in white's court. So you could go and try this this line. I don't know what it should be named. I think Van Forest didn't invent it, because some person, the Nabati from Israel, has played this sometimes, and there is also some Russian players who played it. But I didn't know the line before Van Forest played it, and I played in blitz ever since, and with good results. It's fun. Try it out. Thank you, and I hope you enjoyed this more opening focused video on GM Talks. Thank you.